Welcome to EPG Pathshala. In this module, we will discuss briefly about the genetically modified crops. Starting with the introduction, we know that in the last 20th and 21st century, the human population has increased very rapidly. So, the food demand has also been increased at the large scale. Since agriculture is the primary source of food, therefore, the crop improvement has become necessary so as to meet the food demands of ever-increasing population. Many conventional techniques, including mutagenesis, hybridization, and polypluidy, they have been used by plant breeders to improve the crop production and the quality. However, these techniques are less effective, time-consuming, and desired results may not be obtained even after several generations. Therefore, new techniques involving biological tools such as genetic engineering, they have gained popularity. In this technique, desired characters from other plants or any other organism, they are transferred into the host, that is plant of interest, via genes. These are called as genetically modified plants or crops. Now, genetic engineering tools are elegant because they merge numerous bioscience techniques. The most dominating tool of genetic engineering is rDNA, that is recombinant DNA technology. This technology simplifies the insertion of a gene of interest into the target cell, irrespective of the phenomena, whether they are having genetic similarity or not. However, this technology is not applicable everywhere. There are some products that have been developed using gene silencing methods. For example, decaffeinated coffee, tearless onion. All genetically modified plants, animals, and bacteria, they come under a common term, and that term is known as genetically modified organisms. Now, those crops or plants that contain foreign gene, they are termed as transgenes, transgenic, or genetically engineered plants. The broader term that has been used for transgenics and genetically engineered crops is GMOs, that is genetically modified organisms. Coming to the definition and classification of genetically modified organisms, these organisms, they have been genetically engineered in the laboratory so that the expression of desired traits or the production of desired biological products, they can be favored. Or we can say that genetically modified organism, it means an organism with the exception of human beings, since we know that genetical modification is not applicable in human beings. Therefore, in which the genetic material has been altered in such a way that it doesn't occur naturally by mating or by natural recombination. Or we can say that genetically modified organisms are microorganisms, plants, and animals in which the DNA has been altered, that is, their genome material has been altered by means of gene or cell technology. Now, classification. GM crops, they have been categorized into three generations: first generation, second generation, third generation. First generation includes those genetically modified crops that have been grown from the seeds developed by biotechnological tools. These seeds possess some peculiar properties, like they are resistant to various herbicides, pests, and pathogens. Examples include insect-resistant maize and potato, herbicide-resistant potato, herbicide-resistant soybean. Now coming to the second generation. Second generation includes those GM crops that display increased level of healthy fats, proteins, flavor, micronutrients, and carbohydrates. Examples include rice. Rice contains elevated beta-carotene. Potatoes contain higher calcium content. soya bean, it has been improved with amino acid composition. Tomatoes contain high level of carotenoids and maize contains an increased vitamin C. Third generation of genetically modified organism includes those genetically modified crops that have traits for tolerance against abiotic stress factors. Now, abiotic stress factors including thermal, salinity and drought resistance. The genetically modified crops included in the third generation, they can also have traits that provide health profit. Examples include recombinant antithrombin is the first human drug that is having biological origin from goat's milk. This question is very, very important from the competitive point of view. Now, coming to the history part of genetic modification and genetic modified crops. In 1859, Charles Darwin published his scientific literature on the origin of species by means of natural selection. This is an also important question and it laid the foundation of evolutionary biology. In 1865, Gregor Mendel, he is known as father of genetics, he performed hybridization experiments with plants and discovered that genes were responsible for the transmission of hereditary information. In 1869, Friedrich Miescher, he was a Swiss physician and biologist. He isolated nucleic acid. Nucleic acid, as we know, it can be DNA or it can be RNA. So he isolated nucleic acid from white blood cells. In 1902, chromosomal theory of inheritance was developed by Sutton and Bowrey. In 1944, Avery, MacLeod and McCarty, they demonstrated that DNA was the transforming material in the cell. In many competitive questions like CSIR, this question always comes. In 1953, double helical structure of DNA was described by Watson and Crick. In 1966, genetic code was cracked by Nirenberg and Methei. In 1983, genetically modified tobacco and petunias with antibiotic resistance were developed. In 1990, this was a major achievement in the field of genetic modification. Now, since this time, Human Genome Project was launched. In 1991, gene therapy trials were conducted on the human beings for the first time, but since now, it has not been legalized. Next, coming to the global scenario of genetically modified crops. Commercialization of genetically modified crops, it was started in the year 1996 with an area of 1.75 million hectares. Increase in the area and production of genetically modified crops represents the good adoption of these crops throughout the world by small as well as large farmers during the time period of 20 years, that is from 1996 to 2016. In these 20 years, 2 billion hectares, they have been covered under genetically modified crops, which comprise of 1 billion hectare of genetically modified soybean, 0.6 billion hectares of genetically modified maize, 0.3 and 0.1 billion hectare of genetically modified cotton and canola respectively. Now, it has been estimated that these genetically modified products, they provide food as well as shelter to 7.4 billion people. It is predicted that it would be up to 9.9 billion by 2050 and 12.3 billion in 2100. Top three countries, this is an important question, top three countries, that is USA, Brazil and Argentina, they have 39%, 27% and 13% area respectively under genetically modified crops. Now, there are some genetically modified crops that have been approved for cultivation on commercial scale. First one is bean, and it is also known as Physiolus bulgaris. It provides resistance against viral diseases. Second one is apple. Its scientific name is Melis domestica, and it provides protection against, it is used as an antibiotic and provides browning resistance. Argentine canola, it is also known as Brassica napus. Modification in fatty acid content, glufosinate, glyphosate, and auxinil herbicide tolerance. Melon, Cucumis melo, it provides antibiotic resistance and allows delayed ripening. Then comes plum, it is antibiotic and viral resistant trait has been introduced in plum. In papaya, antibiotic and viral disease resistance has been introduced. In sugarcane, the scientific name of sugarcane is Saccharum, and it the trait that was introduced in sugarcane was antibiotic resistance and stress tolerance, that is particularly against drought. Now, GM crops in India, research and development and regulations. It is an unfortunate thing that the business of genetically modified crops in India is captured only and only by top multinational companies. Moreover, there are certain reports which suggest that the use of genetically modified crops may add to monoculturing. Now, if this happens, the biodiversity can get devastated and can serve as bio-weapon for the target nation. Trials are going on with GM crops in India, but still the farmers have to rely on the traditional practices and knowledge of farming. Now, there is a case study related to BT cotton production in India. What happened in 2002, Monsanto and Myco, it was a Maharashtra Hybrid Seeds Corporation based company, it got clearance from Genetic Engineering Approval Committee for the plantation of BT cotton in central and southern India. Approximately 55,000 farmers, they decided that they will grow BT cotton. During the initial months, the crop grew very fast and the farmers were very happy. Moreover, there was no attack of worms on the leaves. Now, what else they want? Suddenly, the BT cotton stopped growing and new bud production was stopped in the fourth month. At the peak stage, the crop displayed the symptoms of wilting, leaf drooping and shedding, and the plants dried up. Moreover, there was heavy infestation of bollworm. This resulted in 79% and 100% crop loss in Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh respectively. The cotton crop was totally destroyed by bollworm in Gujarat. The farmers suffered heavy losses and around 200 farmers committed suicide. Loss of 20 million euros was recorded across the country due to the failure of BT cotton in single cropping season. Now, according to the law, if the company is held responsible for variety failure, it will surely provide reimbursement to the farmers. Despite of these rules and regulations, Monsanto didn't provide any sort of compensation. In contrast, Monsanto and Myco, they provided Indian government with the data. They showed the wrong data that showed that plantation of BT cotton was a great success. Decreased production of BT cotton produced havoc in Indian economy. Now, there is a regulatory framework that deals with the genetically modified plants in India. Biosafety concern has led to the development of rules, regulations, guidelines, and policies for safe use, handling, and research and testing of the GM plants and products. In India, there are three main ministries. Now, this is an important point. It should be noted down. In India, there are three main ministries that deal with the biotechnological applications in agriculture. First is Ministry of Agriculture. Second is Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Third is DBT and MST, that is Department of Biotechnology and Ministry of Science and Technology. The rules and regulations that are amended by these three ministries, they cover wide areas of genetically modified organisms and products that are produced across the country. Now, there are six authorized bodies that are associated with the framing of regulatory network, and these are as follows. Recombinant DNA Committee, second one is Review Committee on Genetic Manipulation, third is Genetic Engineering Approval Committee, fourth is Institutional Biosafety Committee, then State's Biosafety Coordination Committee, then District Level Committee, Recombinant DNA Committee. This committee comes under DBT and MST, that is Department of Biotechnology and Ministry of Science and Technology. This committee recommends safe rules and regulations regarding the research of recombinants, their use and their applications. Now, we will discuss all these committees in detail. Firstly, Review Committee on Genetic Manipulation. This committee includes DBT, Indian Council of Medical Research, Indian Council of Agricultural Research, and Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. Its only function is to supervise safety-related issues of those projects that involved genetically modified organisms. Now, keeping in view the environmental safety, it frames down certain procedures with respect to the production, import, and sale of GMOs, that is genetically modified organisms. This committee can also form subgroups that can assist RCGM, Review Committee on Genetic Manipulation, in the preparation of new guidelines. Next committee is Genetic Engineering Appraisal Committee, GEAC. Earlier, this committee was known as Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. This committee comes under Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. This committee is concerned with the mass release of GMOs and their commercialization. Next committee is Institutional Biosafety Committee. This committee comes under DBT and MST. The aim of this committee is to prepare site-specific strategies for the use of GMOs. Any institute that is handling microorganisms must constitute this committee. It means that is it is compulsory that they should constitute such type of committees. This committee will include head of the institute, scientists working with RDNA, RDNA is recombinant DNA, medical expert and a nominee from DBT. Now, next committee is State Biosafety Coordination Committee. This committee comes into action when the safety and control measures are violated while handling GMOs. The main function of this committee is to inspect, examine, and take disciplinary action in case of violation of safety measures. It acts as a nodal agency for the damage assessment and to take control measures. Next committee is District Level Committee. This committee works under the supervision of District Collector. Its main function is to monitor the installation of those safety rules that are employed in the use of GMOs. In short, one can conclude that RDAC performs the advisory function, whereas other committees like IBSC, RCGM, and GEAC, they perform regulatory function. SBCC and DLC, that is District Level Committee, they perform the process of monitoring. Now, recombinant DNA guidelines. According to recombinant DNA guidelines 1990, during the advancement of biotechnology sector in various institutes and industries, recombinant DNA guidelines, they were formulated by Department of Biotechnology in 1990 and further was revised in the year 1994. These revised guidelines, they were regarding the research and development of GMOs, transgenic plants, animals, and effect of their products on environment. Further, these guidelines were revised. Now, revised guidelines for research in transgenic plants. DBT brought separate new guidelines for carrying research in transgenic plants during the year 1998. These guidelines include the guidelines for toxic and allergenic properties of transgenic plants, plant parts like seed and fruit, and it also provides the information regarding the import and export of GMOs for research purpose. Next comes Seed Policy 2002. This policy deals with the varieties of transgenic plants. According to this policy, genetically modified crops, they will be tested under the EPA 1986, that is Environmental Protection Act 1986, for the biosafety and the environment. Now, GM plants, they are imported for research purpose only through National Bureau of Plant Genetic Resources, NBPGR, as per rules of 1986. Genetically modified crops, they are monitored for 2 seasons under coordinated project trials of Indian Council of Agricultural Research. After this, environment and biosafety clearance seeds, they are released for commercial use, and they are monitored for 3 to 5 years regularly by the Ministry of Agriculture and State Departments of Agriculture. Next is Food Safety and Standards Act 2006. Ministry of Food Processing Industries introduced Food Safety and Standards Act 2006. It includes those laws related to food and food safety and standards authority of India, which will provide scientific standards for food products and maintain their manufacturing, storage, distribution, sale, and safe import and export of food products. Food Authority also regulates the limits of food additives, pesticide contaminants, heavy metal concentrations, mycotoxins, and many more active substances. Next comes Plant Quarantine Order 2003. Now, this order came into force on 1st April 2004. It deals with the permission of imported transgenic plant seeds. Permission of imported transgenic seeds is important. It is essential to detect the impact of seeds on environment and agriculture of any nation. National Bureau of Plant Genetic Resources, it acts as competent authority that gives import permit for the transgenic seeds to people and private sector for research purpose after getting permission, that is after getting permission only from DBT and MOEF under 1989 rules. Now, there are certain rules and regulations for the import of GM products under foreign trade policy. Ministry of Commerce and Director General of Foreign Trade, they formulated a new regulation for importing of GM products. This policy deals with the importation of GM plants, products, and living modified organisms, and new conditions were also formulated. Next comes National Environment Policy 2006. This policy states that about new processes for the living modified organisms and information regarding them like health, economic, and environment effect. This policy mainly focuses on environment awareness, information, and education. It also includes certain suggestions for mainstreaming scientifically valid content for environment in curriculum of formal education in all levels. Now, we will see the benefits of GM crops, that is their advantages. Insect resistance. Genetic engineering has been used to make insect resistant plants. It was first achieved by the insertion of BT gene into host plant. What is BT gene? This gene has been obtained from Bacillus thuringiensis, that is a bacteria. This gene confers resistance against insect due to the production of toxins or proteins, and these toxins or proteins, they are known as cry proteins. These toxins, what they do, they bind to the gut of the insects when they are ingested and eventually get killed. Such type of genetic modification makes the process of crop production less expensive and manageable. Second benefit is herbicide resistant crops. Crops like corn, soybean and cotton, they have been developed by a genetic modification. These crops, they possess a particular trait of herbicide resistance. Since these crops are already resistant to herbicides, therefore there is no need of herbicide application. Herbicide resistant crops, they more require less tilling and also prevent the topmost soil from erosion. Next benefit is disease resistance in crops. Genetic engineering has also gifted some disease resistant plants, for example papaya, tomato, potato, etc. Next benefit is enhancement in nutritional quality. Crops like golden rice contains higher content of vitamin A. This has also been produced by genetic engineering technology. Next is application of genetic engineering can also be used to amend the carbohydrate as well as the protein and content of amino acids. For example, alteration in carbohydrate content includes the production of M. flora, that is potato variety. Similarly, sweet lupin presents a good example of modification in protein content, that is enrichment in methionine. Next benefit is upgradation of food processing. Genetic modification can also be used to make food processing smoother. Flavor Saver, produced by Calgene. Calgene was a US based company, is the best example of this technology. The tomato produced by Calgene showed some peculiar properties like delayed ripening and longer shelf life. Similarly, gene editing has been used to alter the composition in potato bulbs. As a result, the potatoes exhibit striking appearance and brightness. Now, next benefit is production of edible vaccines. The technique of genetic engineering has made it possible that bacterial and viral antigens, they can be expressed in edible part of plant cells only. Therefore, transgenic crop may serve as oral vaccines. These vaccines have the capacity to induce the production of antibodies and stimulate the immune system. Since GM crops have benefits, therefore, they will also have certain limitations. If GM crops have beneficial effects, they also have certain negative effects which mark their limits. GM crops have great potential to induce allergic reactions. Digestive stability of these crops or foods should be examined to prevent allergenicity. Next comes other health risks associated with GM crops is toxicity and genetic hazards. The potential sources of these risks include gene of insertion and its expressed protein, leiotropic effects of proteins, disruption of natural genes in the modified organism. For example, Starling variety of mage was genetically induced with a gene from Bacillus thuringiensis to provide insect resistance. The inserted gene expressed Cry9C protein. This protein possessed pesticidal properties. However, consumption of this variety induced strong allergic reaction in consumers. For example, soya bean production with higher content of methionine. The gene that was responsible for the increased content of methionine was isolated from Brazil nuts. Consequently, the consumers, those were sensitive to these nuts, they developed allergy after consumption of transgenic soya bean. Now, gene transfer. Transfer of DNA from genetically engineered foods inside human body cells or bacterial cells in gut is also a matter of concern. DNA of the ingested GM food doesn't go under complete digestion. As a result, DNA fragments, they are absorbed by the gut bacteria or somatic cells of the intestine via the process of horizontal gene transfer. Most of the researchers claim that the ingested DNA of GM crop would be digested totally. However, persons suffering from gastrointestinal diseases, they should be more concerned as it is not clear whether the DNA of GM crop would be fully degraded inside the gut or not. Next limitation is outcrossing. The process of gene transfer from genetically modified plants to other plant species is known as outcrossing. Now, if GM crops are planted in close proximity of related plants, then there are maximum chances that the new traits will be exchanged via pollen. Similar situation was created in case of starling variety of mage. Therefore, various strategies were adopted by different countries so as to minimize mixing and to separate GM crops from traditional crops. Next limitation is enhancement in the content of anti-nutrients. There are certain reports that prove that an increase in the levels of anti-nutrients on the insertion of a foreign gene. These anti-nutrients, they create interference with the consumption of the nutrients. For example, Roundup Ready soybean. Next limitation is disruption of food web. Now, development of insect-resistant plants by a genetic modification is a boon to the farmers. There would be a drastic reduction in the number of major pests. However, minor pests will increase in number. Consequently, the food web will get disrupted. Now, there are certain controversies and oppositions related to GM crops. First one is that scientists, they cannot conduct autonomous research on seeds. Secondly, they have to obtain prior permission from the seed company like Monsanto, DuPont, Syngenta and patent holder. As a result, scientists get frustrated because of the restrictions imposed on them by the industries. Crop scientists are worried about the efficacy of herbicide-resistant plants against glyphosates. Since public funds are shrinking day by day, therefore, scientists are totally dependent on research grant from the funding agencies. A report stated that greater part of GM crops is not developed for poor people of the world. However, they are used in rich countries for the production of highly processed food or as biofuels and animal feed. There is a lack of studies that are focused especially on the safety assessment of GMOs. Moreover, the current safety assessments are insufficient to grab a large amount of the injurious effects of GM crops. In addition to this, risk assessment of GM crops has never been made thoroughly under Indian conditions. Professional and financial conflicts of interest are associated with those studies that are displaying favorable results for GM crops. Several health hazards such as swollen faces, skin itching is also associated with VT crops. Researchers are also studying the reason of infertility and decline in cattle's milk yield due to consumption of BT cotton. Impact of BT cotton has not been studied intensively on soil ecology. Farmers complain of decline in soil productivity after sowing of BT cotton. At last, I would like to conclude that this module led to the conclusion that GM crops have been grown for the last 20 years. These crops are associated with several beneficial and negative effects. There are certain rules, regulations, and guidelines for the handling of GM crops. Lethal effects of GM crops are shown on fertility and gastrointestinal tracts. There should be no restriction on the scientist for seed testing prior to any authorization. Monitoring and surveillance of GM foods should be carried out intensely. Thank you.